PBS Kids!
Oh, use your imagination. Think of what you can do. Use your imagination. That's just the thing to do. Go see when it's raining. You can make the sky blue. Use your imagination. PBS Kids say
you.
Oh, use your imagination. Make all your dreams come true.
Use your imagination. That's just the thing to do.
Kellogg's Frosted Flakes, where they know that the fun of playing and learning together is more than just good, it's great.
Wushan is known throughout the world for his portrayal of the Monkey King. Did I ever tell you I'm his biggest fan?
Many times. Many, many times.
Wushan, did I ever tell you I'm his biggest fan, my fantastically felicitous feline?
I believe you might have mentioned it once or twice.
I always wanted to be in the Beijing Opera. Maybe Wu Sheng will let me perform with him. All I have to do is practice and...
First of all, my dear, you're a cat. Even we have our limitations. And second of all, I can't imagine you being an opera singer.
I thought you said you liked opera.
Oh, I do. In fact, I love opera. But that yowling you make with the alley cats isn't opera. It's just noise.
It is not just noise. We're rehearsing. That's what rehearsals are for.
You certainly spend a lot of time doing it, whatever it is.
You spend just as much time playing five dots.
I do not.
Oh, no.
Let's not argue in front of the children, my dear. Mama! Baba! The Monkey King is here!
Come and see! Come and see!
We still have work to do. We'll see the Monkey King later, all right?
Come on, you two. What are we waiting for?
come to our humble home, Wushan. We are honored to have you here.
We'd be even more honored if you would grace us with a performance. Perhaps of the Monkey King?
I wish I could, but I cannot. I am traveling alone. How can I possibly play the Monkey King without the actors who play my monkeys?
How hard could it be to play a monkey?
I bet you couldn't do it, Fufu. People train years and years to sing opera. It takes lots and lots of practice.
Well, it sounds like a bunch of squealing and screaming, if you ask me.
You're such a silly bat. Come on, let's see what's happening over there.
I see you're playing five dots again.
I don't spend any more time playing five dots than you spend rehearsing your precious opera.
Well, I have to. Those alley cats really need a lot of practice. What we do is art. What you do is just a game.
Art? Art? Oh, yes, you must go and help them sing more artfully. Art indeed. And by the way, I'll have you know that it takes a lot of skill to play five dots well.
Okay, but we better be quiet. Shh. Don't make a sound.
Hi-ya! Oh, not that racket again.
I'm afraid it's the Alley Cat Opera starring the one and only Baba Meow.
That's exactly what it is. Whoever told him he could sing?
I want a word with you, Baba Meow.
Let me guess. Does this have anything to do with our singing?
Yes, it does. Most certainly.
You said you liked opera. As a matter of fact, you said you loved it.
Yes. Real opera.
Oh, no. They're fighting again.
But your brand of so-called opera chased Nine-Eye away while we were playing Five Dots.
I don't see why it would.
And you probably woke everyone else up in the palace, too, while you were at it.
I'll tell you what. Why don't we go for a walk and talk about it?
Well, all right. But don't think you can sweet-talk your way out of this one. I'm warning you, it isn't going to work.
Mama and Baba don't love each other anymore.
What?
What are you talking about?
You saw them. They were arguing.
Shigua. Just because Mama and Baba were arguing, well, it doesn't mean that they don't love each other.
Deng was right, Shigua.
I guess so.
You are sure about this, aren't you, Donghua? Come on, Shigua. We'll talk to Mama and Baba in the morning, okay?
Okay.
You don't really mind me spending some time on my opera, do you?
No, not really. I guess not. Actually, you do have a very strong voice. Very masculine. You don't really mind me playing five dots, do you?
Of course not, my dear. Your skill is unmatched. I'm proud of your playing.
Good morning, Wushan. I hope you slept well. Is there anything you need? Anything we can do for you?
Well, I do need to rehearse. So if there is a suitable room in your magnificent palace...
Anywhere you wish.
Thank you, my kind friend.
Why did you want to talk to us, children?
Well, you and Mama do love each other, right?
Of course we do.
Well, we all heard you arguing last night. And Shigua is afraid you and Baba don't love each other anymore.
Hmm.
We're very sorry you heard the argument, but we do love each other very much.
And we love you very much, too. And we always will.
Everyone argues sometimes. Even you, Shigwa. Every so often you argue with Sagwa and Dongwa, right?
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean you don't love them, does it?
No, of course I love them.
In fact, sometimes arguing with people you care about makes you realize just how important they are to you.
Come on! Let's go see what the Monkey King is doing!
Oh, Wushan, does this mean you've changed your mind about performing?
Sorry, I'm just practicing. I cannot perform without my monkeys.
Here are your monkeys, Wushan. They'd be perfect.
Well, that is...
I insist. What a wonderful idea. We have so little opportunity to go to the opera, and the magistrate is so fond of the Monkey King.
Well, all right. I'll give it a try. Oh!
No!
Out! I'm so sorry, Wushan. I have no idea where these kittens came from.
No, wait! I found my monkeys. They're naturals. All they need is a bit of rehearsal. I will perform as the Monkey King.
Ha!
Yeah!
Ladies and gentlemen, the Monkey King!
Anybody could have done that. Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Well, you couldn't have.
Could too.
No way! Well, now I guess we're having an argument. Mm-hmm.
But we're still friends, right?
The best!
Uh-oh, I think I hear another argument coming on.
And this one might not have such a friendly ending.
Uh-oh. Something tells me I shouldn't be sticking around here.
I am a curious cat, and I'm always on the lookout for ways to have fun. I think making and listening to music is great, although what some consider to be music worth listening to, others do not.
You sing with the voice of a thousand angels.
Stop it! Stop it!
See what I mean? Now, crickets are not considered to be a traditional Chinese instrument, but this is... This is a mato chin, which means horse head fiddle. It's like a violin, but is held straight up and down and placed on the ground, and it only has two strings. Some people think it sounds like the movement and sound of a horse. Listen, what do you think? What about you? Do you make music?
The pieces that I play are sometimes hard, but still they're beautiful. For example, one song is The Dance of Hours. Dun 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 dun. Once I asked my mom to play Dance of the Hours, and then me, and then the baby, and then my baby sister and I began dancing. Since it said Dance of Hours, each time I learn a new song, I like it.
Now that was a great story. Hear that? There's Palestinian music in the air. Sometimes what makes music sound different are the instruments used to make the music. Nai, tabla, oud, kanun, daf. Put them all together and you have an Arabic orchestra. I guess people everywhere like the sound of music.
Oh, what about you?
Sogwa, as you know, tomorrow is your mother's birthday.
Yes, I can't wait.
And as a surprise for her, I've written this little operatic song. I want you to take it to Singbad for me. He'll sing it for her tomorrow evening.
But, Baba, why don't you sing it yourself?
Oh, my sweet little Sogwa, you know your mother can't stand my singing. So please, take this to Singbad for me. Your mother and I have some work to do for the magistrate, and if I go into the village, she will wonder where I am. It will ruin the surprise.
You can count on me, Baba. I'll do it for you.
Thank you.
So, where does Singbad live?
He lives in the bell tower of that big pagoda past the village. And I want you to hurry. You need to be back home before sunset.
Don't worry, Papa. I'll deliver the scroll and be back before you know it. I can't wait to hear your opera.
Would you like to hear just a bit before you go? All right. Here's the song. I'm Singban, sick by fun, Koyut King Oling Chan Cha Hei Sun, Lightin Yao Yan, Yu Fai Hao Kao Agin, Kyu Chai Dai Ayun. I must go. The master calls.
But wait! I don't know where Singbad's pagoda is. I don't know how to get there or what to do when...
Don't worry, Sogwa. I know where Singbad lives.
Fufu, what are you doing here?
I'll help you get to Singbad's. I know right where it is. Don't worry. Fufu will be at your service.
Thanks, Fufu.
My pleasure.
We're going to have such an adventure making our way to Singbad's pagoda.
Uh-oh. Huh? My bats are calling me. Something must be up at home. I'll be back in a few minutes. And then we'll go to Singbad's house.
Yes, such an adventure. I bet it's over the river. And there'll be storms, probably. And maybe we'll have to go over the mountains. Oh. But I want to make Baba proud of me. And I want Mama to have the best birthday ever. You can count on me, Baba. I'll do it for you. Where'd Fufu go? It's getting late. But I can't find Singbad's pagoda unless he... Hey, where have you been?
The bats have decided to move to a new cave. They say there's better lucky feng shui higher up the hill. Oh, I can't go with you.
But how will I get to Singbad's without you?
Not so hard, not so difficult. Really easy, in fact, if you know the way. I'll just give you the direction. Piece of mooncake. Take two turns to the right of the crossroads and double back through the rice paddy.
Okay, the rice paddy?
And then go over Puzzle Lock Bridge. And then take the straight road into the village. You'll be there at Singbad's pagoda, no problem. Call me if you need me. I got my sonar turned up.
But wait! What's the combination to the lock on the bridge? And turn right at the crossroads. And double back through the rice paddy. But here's the lake. Fufu did say turn right. Where's the rice paddy? Uh-oh. Maybe he meant turn left. Oh, good! That must be Puzzle Lock Bridge. Wow, this looks complicated. And I don't know the combination. How am I gonna get across? Fufu, help!
Back, down, out of my way! Sheesh! Okay, great, you got here. My directions worked. See, I told you. I can't seem to find the new cave.
What's the combination, Fufu? I can't get through the gates.
Yeah, the combination, right. Let me think. Oh, that's right. Simple, simple, simple. You just tickle the lion's tummy, rotate this little thing here until the lion smiles. Okay, now turn this other thing once or twice to the left, or maybe it's to the right. Whoa! I gotta go. I'm gonna be in the doghouse if I don't find that new cave. I'll see you at Sinbad.
Fufu said to the left. I'll try to the right. That was once. Here goes twice. No! It's locked itself again. It'll take forever to figure this out. I guess I could swim. Oh my gosh! The water is too cold! Too rough! I can never swim across that! Oh, it's no use. I can't do this. No, that is not an option. I've got to figure this out. Maybe there's another way to get across the river. Like that basket. It'll be just like a boat. Oh, too far out. If I just had a little bridge, I could get into it. Maybe if I bend these over, I can walk across them to the basket. Yuck! All wet. Yes! Now I can float across the river. I'm going nowhere. Yeah, sure. Maybe there's another way up.
Where is Baba's opera? I'll never be able to learn that song by tomorrow night if the music doesn't get here.
Fufu! I need you!
Out! Sorry to leave you hanging.
So, what are we going to do?
Let's see. Just wiggle in through those spaces in the tiles up there. Then scoot up the stairs to Sinbad's attic. Mission accomplished.
Maybe there's another way. Up we go.
Close one. Anyway, gotta fly, Sagwa. Jaijin, my friend. Good luck.
But
I gotta keep moving. To the new cave, that is.
Aha! Baba Meow's kitten. You're here. And just in time, too. I've got to get to work on this if I'm gonna sing it at your mother's birthday celebration tomorrow night. Now, let me see that scroll of your papa's. How can I work with this? There's no way I can read this. No way I can learn it.
hence, no way I can sing it. Your parents are going to be very disappointed.
Wait! 1 minute, please. I have another idea. My Baba sang it to me. I think I remember how it goes, sir.
Horum sin bun, seek by fun, koyut wingo ling chun jiao hei sun.
What am I interrupting?
I ruined the scroll. I was trying to remember the opera, but I can't remember the ending.
Excuse me, but I was hanging around too, so I heard Mr. Meow sing the song. I can remember the next part. So, hit it, Sagwa!
Orm sin bun, seek by fun, koyo ringo lin chun jiao hei sun, hoi ding yao yun, you fai hoi cow again, you chai dai yun.
I think he's got it now. You did it, Sagwa!
Thank you, Fufu, for all your help.
You did your job. I just helped out a little. Now get home and fast. Jai-jin, 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 my friend.
This is a big moment for me, Sagwa. My first opera. And I could not have done it without your help. I'm very proud of you. Thank you. Now I must go and introduce Sinbad to our guests. My friends, tonight is a very special night for me. Not only is it the premiere of my first opera, but even more importantly, it is the joyous celebration of my dear wife's birthday. I have written this song for her. And to sing it to her, I give you the incomparable Sinbad. Happy birthday, my dear sweet wife.
Om sin bun, seek by fun.
Hoyo kin o lin chun chow hei sun. Hoy kin ya yun.
You fai hoi kawa gin.
You chai dai yun.
Animals are a big part of our world. I guess I'm just one among many. Not all animals people talk about are real, like the dragon. In China, the dragon is very important. It is a symbol of strength and goodness. He also represents the spirit of change. Depending on what he wants, he can be seen or be invisible. He can become as small as a worm or large as the sky. The Chinese call themselves the children of the dragon. Today, the dragon symbolizes the entire Chinese nation. What about you? Can you create a mythical animal?
If I could make up any animal, it would be a flying and talking leopard that I could ride. It would also be tame. If it were to fly upside down, I would clutch onto it with its stomach. I would ride my animal and go to, like, places, because it could go to imaginary places. I would go to the places in the books I've read. My parents would take out an extra blanket for it to sleep on, because in a forest or a jungle or a rainforest, a leopard doesn't have such a soft place to sleep on. I would name my animal Arrow.
Now that's a great story. What other mythical animals are there? The unicorn. This mythical animal looks like a horse with a long spiral horn right in the middle of its forehead. The horn was thought to have magical powers, like taking poisons out of rivers and bringing dead people back to life. Today, this animal symbolizes purity and love. So, whether it's a dragon, a flying leopard, or a unicorn, people all over the world love the magic and power of mythical animals.
What about you?
Bet you 10 grains of rice you can't do it.
I'm a cat. I can do this in my sleep. Not a
Now, my dear daughters, pay close attention. When applying color to your lips, be steady of hand and spare of color. Like this. Ay-ya! Tongue!
Every time I turn around, the rules are being ignored. Must I see to everything myself? And another thing, Oh, tongue, you sing with the voice of a thousand angels. What a treasure you are.
Stop singing! I can't nap, I can't enjoy my garden, I can't even have a peaceful meal, and all because of his horrible screeching! I must end this once and for all!
Magistrate is sad because Tongue, his cherished cricket, has passed away.
But I heard Tongue singing just yesterday.
Here, husband. It was just a cricket. I'm sure you could find...
Why?
So quiet.
We are mourning the passing of Tongue.
What is mourning?
Shh. It's a time to be quiet and remember what Tongue meant to us.
Perhaps a funeral is too much for Sagwa to deal with. Why don't you go and play by the pond?
What did Tongue mean to me?
What's everybody doing?
Well, they're having a funeral for Tongue. Ah! Whoa! Who are you Tongue's ghost?
I don't think so. Nope, not a ghost.
But if you're here, who's in the cage?
Let me tell you, my furry friend. I was doing a beautiful rendition of one of my favorite songs.
Come in, my little friend. We're going on a trip. My good man! Take the cricket in this box to a field far, far away. Watch out for his singing.
And
the vendor dropped me into a field that was far, far away from here.
No.
Yes, but what he didn't know was that when he wasn't looking, I hopped into his cart and came right back into town with him.
Wow. But who's in the cage?
I don't know. Maybe Tai-Tai found a dead cricket in the garden and put it in the cage for the magistrate to find.
I can't believe Tai-Tai would be so mean.
What I don't understand is why she kept going on about my horrible singing. I have the voice of 1,000 angels. The magistrate said so. Let me demonstrate.
Now isn't a good time. Uh-oh.
I wonder if I did the right thing.
Okay, she's gone. Sounds like somebody's feeling a little guilty.
Yeah, but it doesn't look like she's doing anything about it.
Well, maybe she just needs someone to give her the idea.
You think so?
Ah, peace and quiet. Oh, maybe too quiet. My beloved husband did enjoy Tang's singing, so...
Yeah!
What? I must be hallucinating. It's no use. I feel so guilty for getting rid of Tang. I hear his horrible singing everywhere I go.
The next person to anger me will be banished. Do you hear me?
What have I done? My dear husband hasn't been the same without Tang. I must find some way to make him feel better. I'll just have to find Tang and bring him back. It's the only way. Who knows? Maybe his singing isn't as bad as I remember.
What does she mean bad? I have the voice of 1,000 angels. Tai-Tai sure has been gone a long time.
Huh? All that searching and no Tang. Well, it isn't Tang, but perhaps it will cheer my husband anyway. Quiet. Perhaps you'll sing for the magistrate later on. Now to get my husband so he can see his new cricket and be happy again.
Whoa there! Are you trying to give me a heart attack? I have my singing career to think about.
Shh! I just wanted to wish you luck.
Why can't you just tell me what it is, my lotus petal?
Dear husband, I know that you have been sad since Tang passed away, so I have gotten you another cricket to lift your spirits.
No one will ever take the place of my dear old Tang. He looks a little common, but will he sing for me?
Yeah!
Oh! He's not quite Tang, but he does have the voice of 500 angels. Thank you, dear wife.
Huh.
Kellogg's Fruit Loops is proud to sponsor programming that stimulates children's growth and sense of adventure.
Doink.
Thank you, Your Grace. I promise you'll have the most glorious new robe.
I hope so. My banquet is 1 month away, and I expect to look even better than my usual best. What is all that commotion? It's those plain brown birds. How dare they interrupt us? Quiet, all of you!
Huh? Uh-oh. Tai Tai seems really mad.
Psst! Donghua, over here! Let's go play!
Who's that?
It's my new friend, Xiaobao. His family just moved to our village.
He's really cool.
Coming!
And who brought those useless birds here in the first place? They're not fit for a palace.
Well, my precious Plum, I suppose the Swiftlets were here before we were.
I want them removed. Not only are they noisy, but they are simply too plain. They must be banished from the province.
Whoa! Anything for you, my lovely lychee.
We're Ti Chensu masters!
No one is faster.
No one will be really fun. I'll sneak you into the palace for the big banquet next month.
Yeah, that'd be great. We can... Oh, no. I just remembered. I'm moving at the end of the month.
You're leaving?
My dad's a rat chaser. We're always moving from one place to another.
But you just got here.
I know. But we have a whole month to play. Ready?
It's kind of getting late. I gotta go.
I can't believe the Swiftlets left already.
Great. Everybody's leaving.
Hey! They're cute. Huh? We can do tricks too.
mulberry trees beautiful this time of year?
Oh! What is this hideous creature? These parasites are eating my mulberry trees!
But you don't understand. Those aren't parasites. They're still...
An infestation!
But I...
They must go at once! Hmm?
Have you guys seen Dogwa? I can't find him anywhere.
He was here a minute ago. Ah! I'm afraid of bees.
He didn't mean to bother you. He's probably just on his way to eat some flower nectar. See? When bees eat, pollen gets on their bodies. And when they go from flower to flower, the pollen gets spread, and that helps the flowers grow.
How come you know so much?
Well, me and my family travel a lot. We're moving again in a few weeks.
What is it, my lotus blossoms?
Bees!
Ah, bees! Help! Help!
What's the matter?
A bee stung me on the hand.
Oh, you poor dear. Cook, get me some salve. Those vicious beasts! We'll make sure this never happens again, won't we, dear? Dearest! I want you to draft a new law immediately. From now on...
I know. The bees are banished from the palace.
Oh, now the bees are gone, too. If this keeps up, we'll be the only animals left.
But the flowers need the bees.
That's right, Shigwa. All of nature is connected by an invisible thread. Once you break it, things can fall apart.
If we were the only animals left, it would be awful around here.
Dongwa! Dongwa, there you are! Tichensu Masters?
Maybe tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Maybe next time.
Dongwa, that wasn't very nice.
What difference does it make? He's moving anyway.
I know it's hard when friends leave.
Especially Xiaobao. He was really fun, and it's hard to make new friends.
You're right. But you know what? I'm sure it's pretty hard for Xiaobao, too. Especially moving all the time.
Yeah, I guess.
Let's see tonight's menu for the banquet. Bird's nest soup, imperial vegetables, roast duck, and cassia flower cakes. Yum! Makes you hungry, doesn't it?
What's the matter with Dongwa?
I think he's sad because Xiaobao's leaving tonight.
I'm just not hungry, that's all.
Uh-oh.
I hope my new robe is as glorious as you promised.
Your Grace, I must explain.
Don't be modest. I'm sure it's the finest robe in all of China. What is the meaning of this? It's not even finished.
There's been a shortage of silk, Your Grace, since you banished the silkworms.
Silkworms? You mean those ugly insects made my beautiful silk?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well... There's still a wonderful meal to enjoy.
Ooh.
I've been looking forward to this delicacy all year. Bird's nest? Why, this is a simple broth. What happened to the bird's nest soup?
1,000 pardons, Your Grace. But since the swiftlets were banished, there were no...
Bird's nests for the soup.
It must be time for the cassia flower cakes.
Ah, yes, I almost forgot. Mmm, that will make up for everything. But there's something missing. It's So
bland.
I did my best, Your Grace, but there's no honey since you
banished the bees.
It was a lovely banquet tonight, wasn't it, my perfect peach? Well, yes, I guess it could have been better.
It was a disaster, and it's all my fault. And yours. Oh, what am I saying? I've made a terrible mistake. Birds, bees, worms. I never stopped to think that my selfish needs would make such a mess.
It's not too late, my fastidious fungi. We can always bring those creatures back.
Yes, of course. We've got to send that message out tonight.
We're so glad you changed your mind. Now we can have all the silk robes, honey, and bird's nest soup we want.
I know you miss those things, and you probably never even thought about where they came from, unlike me. But, dear daughters, perhaps we should be less focused on what these creatures give us and think more about the delicate balance of nature that they help create.
The message is all ready to go, but I'm afraid we'll have to wait until morning for the messenger to carry it to the next province.
There must be some way to deliver that message right now. It is time you were more than just the most beautiful bird in China. Do something useful around here for a change. Now go! Shoo, shoo!
I can't wait for our friends to come back. I never thought any of them were ugly.
I'm just glad Tai Tai changed her mind before it was too late. And they were gone forever.
Xiaobao, wait up!
Dongua! I thought you didn't want to be my friend anymore.
No, I guess I just didn't want to say goodbye. This is for you.
Whoa! Thank you, Dongua! Tichen Shi Masters?
No one is faster!
Yum! Some of my favorite times of the day are meal times. And dessert time is super yummy. I bet you agree. But did you know that desserts really aren't that big a deal in China? In fact, a typical dessert would be fresh fruit or candied ginger. Sweet dishes are eaten at big banquets or holidays, but not every day. One of my all-time favorite desserts are mooncakes. We eat these during the Moon Festival, an important Chinese holiday. It's like a cookie, stuffed with different sweet fillings. Some mooncakes have an egg yolk in the middle, which looks like a bright moon. These delicious round cakes symbolize family togetherness. One last thing. Did you know that Chinese fortune cookies aren't really Chinese at all? They are an American invention. What about you? Do you have a favorite dessert?
Kisses, lollipops, and other kinds of candies. I love piñatas because it's fun to hit them and it's fun to jump in and get all the candy. I would normally hit it sideways, or if it has a flat bottom, I would hit it upwards. If I could make a piñata, I would probably make a big humongous lollipop.
Now that's a great story. My sweet tooth is throbbing. My other sweet tooth wants to go to Russia, where they're making rowan berry jam. Yummy! Jam is very popular in Russia. The berry for this jam comes from the rowan tree, which some people believe has magical powers. You can eat these berries right off the tree, even if they are pretty bitter. But add a little sugar while you cook, and ta-da! A delicious jam. It seems people all over the world have one big sweet tooth.
What about you?
worst storm I've ever seen.
Me too.
Takes more than a little storm to scare me.
Now this afternoon you must play outside. The magistrate is having an award ceremony for a very brave hero.
What hero, Mama?
Last night during the storm, he saved two men whose boat was sinking.
Really?
Wow!
That's brave!
So under no circumstances can you be in the palace this afternoon. And as a reward, tonight I'll take you to the hero's parade.
A hero's parade? Wow!
One of these days, I'm gonna be a big hero, just like that one who saved the men in the storm.
It'll be pretty hard for you to save someone from a storm when you're hiding under your covers.
What was that?
Don't worry. Even if it's a ferocious, hungry lion, I'll use my kung fu to push back its paw, grab it by the tail, and twirl it around and around.
Whoa, calm down. Deep breaths. In, out, in. Listen, I've never heard of anything big and ferocious around here, but if it makes you feel better, I'll check it out. I'm okay. Just as I thought. They're just a bunch of scaredy cats. I'm okay.
Huge claws! That must be a giant.
There! Maybe he's going to attack the village.
We should tell someone so he can be captured.
Wait a second. Are you crazy? This could be our big chance.
For what? To be dim sum for a bear?
No, this is our big chance to be heroes. Big heroes. I bet they'd even have a parade for us.
Hold on. How are we going to catch a mean giant bear?
I have the perfect plan. Okay, Fufu, you and I make noise and chase him into the trap. Ready, Sogwa?
Ready!
Just a little bear.
We can't capture a baby bear. There's nothing brave about that.
Well, we'd be bigger heroes if we caught a bigger bear, but I'll settle for being any size hero I can. Come on. We got you now, bear.
Wait, we're not supposed to go in the palace today. Remember? The magistrate's award ceremony.
hero ceremony is starting.
This isn't good.
The magistrate does hereby decree that Ji Yun Fong performed with great heroism in the face of great adversity.
Watch it!
Oh!
Which way should we go now?
Shh! He's in Tai Tai's room. After him, Fufu!
Me? You go after him!
Oh, no! You go! I'll wait here so I can pounce on him when he comes out!
Works every time!
We got you surrounded now. What do you have to say for yourself, you bear?
Oh, great. What do we do now?
I don't know. Talk to him, I guess. Hey there. I'm Sagwa.
I'm Ling Ling.
Why are you crying, Ling Ling?
Why am I crying? First, that thunderstorm scared me. Then I got lost from my family. And now you keep chasing me. You'd cry, too.
Look, we just wanted to catch you before you attacked the village.
So we'd be big heroes, and then they'd have a parade for us.
I don't want to attack your village.
Could you maybe pretend like you want to until after we get our own parade?
No, I just want to go home.
Forget the parade. We have to get him out of here and back to where he lives.
What about being heroes?
We'll just have to wait for another time.
And a bigger bear.
Not only putting his own needs aside, but facing danger head-on and with unnerving courage.
I don't know, Donghua. Are you sure we have to do this?
Trust me. No one's seen him yet, but we can't take a chance. Okay, Ling Ling. Nice and slow to the door.
Someone's coming. Run!
No! Ling Ling!
Whoa.
I can't look.
Sorry, it was getting too hot in there. Back home in the mountains, it's nice and cool.
You live in the mountains? Well, that makes it easy to get you home.
Yeah, there's only like a gazillion mountains around here.
So, what do you like to do for fun, Ling Ling?
Oh, you know, eat bamboo, watch bugs, play in the waterfall.
A waterfall! I know a mountain with a waterfall. You keep walking that way. I'll go see if I can find Ling Ling's family. I meant to do that.
Looks like you'll be home soon, Ling Ling. You can count on Fufu.
A wild dog!
Run! Run! Hurry!
Faster! I didn't know pandas climbed trees.
Really?
We Xiangnao are called giant cat bears. I guess that kind of makes us cousins.
I hate to interrupt this family reunion, but maybe we should try to get rid of that wild dog.
Let's all make noise together. Maybe we can scare it that way. One, two, three.
Wow, Ling Ling, that was one weird noise.
It wasn't me.
Mama!
Ling Ling!
Must have got some
dirt in my eye.
And I want you to have these necklaces as awards for helping me and my little Ling Ling find each other again. You are all heroes.
Big heroes!
You heard what Ling Ling's mother called us? Heroes! Big heroes!
Too bad there's no parade.
Who says? This parade goes all the way back to the village.
Hey, maybe next time we can try to catch something really scary.
A lion!
Oh, or a huge elephant! Or a...
Dongwa!
Animals are a big part of our world. I guess I'm just one among many! In China, many people have pets. Cats, goldfish, and birds are all popular. Kids particularly have enjoyed crickets as pets. They were traditionally kept as pets for two reasons. One was for cricket fights, a popular sport. The other reason's a little nicer. People enjoyed the music they make.
I have the voice of a thousand angels.
Crickets are a symbol of courage and a symbol of summer. That's nice, and I'm sure crickets are a nice pet to have, but in my opinion, cats rule. What about you? Do you have a pet?
I love hermit crabs because they bond together. They live in this sort of cage, and it's like a small world, but to them it takes a whole day to, like, schlep across the tank. I have three of them, Phyllis, Courtney, and Big Abe. One day we found one of my little ones had buried himself completely under the water bowl. We couldn't find him. It took us a couple of days. It was really scary, but he was right under there, minding his own business. I always had hermit crabs. I love them.
Now that's a great story. Pets make a lot of people happy. This girl in Australia has some unusual pets. That's because her mother rescues sick animals. They get phone calls when a new case comes in, like this baby opossum. While the animals are living with Emily and her mother, they're loved and cared for as pets. But the goal is to help the animals get better as fast as possible so they can return to their natural environment. Even though she doesn't keep the animals as pets for long, Emily gets to meet and care for a lot of different creatures. So whether it's a cricket, a hermit crab, or an opossum, people all over the world like to care for pets.
What about you?
There's nothing like spreading your wings in the open sky. It's... Wow! What was that music? Uh-huh! You went that away, did you?
Going to arrive.
I'm sure it will be here soon, Your Magistrate.
Well, I'm glad one of us is sure. Go check.
But, Your Magistrate, I just got back from checking and... I'll go check.
I wonder what he's waiting for.
There you are! How could such a small case take so long to push? No. No need to explain. I'll just take it in myself.
It's going to be great to have a new friend to fly with.
At last!
Oh? Huh?
This is Pingwing.
Hmm.
It is a great honor to receive such a musical gift from the Emperor.
Musical? That scrawny little pigeon?
Don't pay any attention to them, my little friend. Tomorrow we'll show them just how musical you really are.
Wow, Pingwing looks like fun.
You say so.
Hi, Pingwing. My name's Sagwa. Do you want to hang around with me? I know this place inside out and backwards.
Sure. Sounds great to me, Sagwa.
I can also show you how to paint if you like.
Oh, I've never done that before, but I'll give it a try. And I can show you how to make music when you fly.
I don't know how to fly.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
But I do!
Hi, Fufu. This is my new friend, Pingwing.
Your friend? Huh. Pingwing and I go way back. Right, pal?
Quick, the magistrate.
Come along, Pingwing. You need a good night's sleep before tomorrow's performance.
I saw Pingwing first, you know.
What difference does that make?
She's going flying with me tomorrow.
Tomorrow? But you and I made plans to go pick lychees tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Besides, Pingwing's going to paint with me tomorrow.
No, she's flying.
Painting.
Flying.
Oh, hi, Rita.
Are you ready? It's time for our game of Pie Joe.
Look, I don't really feel like playing tonight.
You never want to play anymore.
It's because I started doing Tai Chi.
I can see you need all the practice you can get.
Yes, and daybreak is the best time to do it. So, I have to...
So you have to go to bed early. No time for Pie Joe or for me. Mm-hmm. Well... If you ever decide you want to play Pie Joe with your oldest friend again, you be sure to let me know.
I'm gonna show you all around the palace, and then we can do some painting together like we talked about.
Yeah, great!
Hey there, Pingwing! Morning, Sagwa. Hey, do you want to go exploring today, Pingwing? I can show you the giant statue.
Pingwing can't go with you. She's going to paint a picture with me. And everyone knows you can't paint, Fufu.
My melodious mango. Prepare yourself for the most beautiful music a bird has ever made.
I simply don't know why you're making such a big fuss over this little pigeon.
Fly, Pingwing! Fly!
Ah. Ooh, that's more lovely than I'd ever imagined.
Looks like your painting will just have to wait while I go flying with my friend Pingwing. I guess you can't come with us, huh? Everyone knows you can't fly, Sagwa. Bye.
Could you give me a hand? Well, that wasn't very nice. Oh, maybe I haven't been very thoughtful myself lately.
And that's the pagoda over there.
Nice tour, Fufu.
Thank you.
bad you couldn't come with us. We had so much fun.
Yeah, I bet.
Well, it was more fun than painting silly pictures.
How would you know? You've never painted anything in your life.
That's it! Enough already! Why are you two fighting anyway? I bet you don't even know.
I know that Sagwa started it.
I did not. You started it.
I don't care who started it. All I know is this is no fun.
See? You're no fun.
No, you're no fun.
No, you're no fun.
How could I have been so selfish?
What is Pingwing's problem anyway?
Yeah, why is she being so crabby?
Oh, come on. You don't know? Pingwing's problem is the two of you.
Us? What did we do?
Yeah, all we wanted was to do stuff with Pingwing. Which meant we weren't doing stuff together.
Oh, we never did go lychee picking, did we?
Nope. We got too caught up fighting with each other.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
I'm so sorry. I wasn't looking where I was going.
No, it was my fault. Where were you going in such a hurry?
I was coming to see if you still wanted to play Paijo with me.
But my friend, you're Tai Chi.
I know. I got all caught up in Tai Chi. It was so new. But I never meant for it to get in the way of something so old. Our friendship. I am giving up Tai Chi. What's so funny?
I was on my way to tell you I was giving up Paijo so I could start doing Tai Chi.
We really have a problem now, don't we?
Can you think of any reason why we can't do both?
Well, we could play Paijo earlier in the evening.
And it wouldn't do me any harm to get up earlier in the morning.
Hi, Pingwing. Hello.
It's all right, Pingwing. We aren't fighting anymore.
We came to say we're sorry.
Yeah, we were a pain.
No, you weren't a pain. You were two pains. But since you're not fighting anymore, why don't we all do something fun together?
Yeah!
Painting!
Flying!
Uh-oh. Not again.
I still can't fly.
And I still can't paint.
Tomorrow we can plan time for both. Painting with Sagwa and flying with Fufu. But what can we all do together today?
There you go. That's it.
Just like this.
Hey, I'm doing it.
Me too.
Well, sort of.
Look, I think I'm getting the hang of it too. Whoa.
Kellogg's Fruit Loops is proud to sponsor programming that stimulates children's growth and sense of adventure.
chicka-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-